Hello, so this video will have timestamps, but for now we'll just go over the events like in the most, I don't know, efficient way. So let's hear the mine vessel first.
Żaden wyrmyć, że mój naszurek nie mój marowy. Że mój naszurek nie mój marowy.
Sure.
I że mój do wejle będzie, że mój naszurek nie... Krzyk dobrze kuć.
Że mój naszurek nie... Nie rusz. Nie mój narod.
What are you?
To jest kuśma. Kuć żurny. To jest.
What?
Nie. Tuk. Nie rozwiesz toć.
The sentence as a sensation.
Marysz, tak wiesz. Nie rozumiesz to, wyciekasz wej, pierdolisz użeń.
Wait? Okay, that was very, very interesting, but at the same time very dangerous. So that's the mine we have. We will find, I mean, I already found it in the freight. The port and then the freight. So you'll actually find here the infused column, the recipe. And now people are wondering, well, how do you use it? Well, it's pretty easy. Let me show you the recipe first. Remember that some recipes only will appear in the right building. So let's go over here. I mean, we could take the road, but it's a bit too... It's a bit too much to wait. Ah, come on, I hate. Why does this sometimes cancel? Visit, yes. Ah! Okay, probably doesn't let me because it's too close, but still, it's a silly mechanic. Something not working just because the game doesn't tell you why, okay. So next we have to craft it. But yeah, that's a weird oversight from the developer's part. I mean, it should be able to send you right up here. They said they'll cancel the Axiom cost for traveling, but still, yeah. Okay, so for now we'll craft the infused column. Now, during this time, we'll actually explain a few things. To access a crafting station that can craft infused column, you just need to get to an occult crafting station. There are only two that I found so far, but I think there are more. One is in the freight area, of course, so that's the Isidon port. And it's a bit tricky to get there. I mean, you can teleport depending on where you have your polarized ones, polarized bridges, or you can just go to the first area of the game, which has one. And it's kind of a secret. Now the... I'm hurrying, don't rush me. Now the code was only shown on a stream for Angry Joe, so I guess the developers wanted to do that only then. I'm not really sure if the code is in the game right now, but from what I know, the code was not found in the game, so it was for a live stream, and people just, you know, copied that and it remained there. Remember, the game had a demo, which was pretty good, but it also showed some parts of the game that were meant for later gameplay. So that's why some people are a bit confused about now, and some videos will show you something else. They still need elevator music. Remember, this is a secret. If you haven't found this area yet, well, you'll get more out of it. What was that? He dodged by... Ah, okay. It was funny how he dodged that. Yes, over here, as you can see, someone already marked it. If you are playing online, you'll see a lot of marks. And I guess it was also marked over here, yeah. So... some people will not be happy about this, but what can I do? Ah, you don't scare me after the 100th time. So print model, and then we'll actually go to the luggage area. Now my column actually is plus 4, I think. Yeah, it's plus 4. So white tempering, we have all the materials needed. But let's look at our original weapon. So it's plus 4, right? And remember that this will be an infuse column, which actually will need, only has 24 damage because it doesn't have the mastery to it. But it needs strength and some foresight. So let's craft it. Have to press Q. Yes, I want to print that model. And this is not like Dark Souls. You actually keep your original weapon after you craft something, even though you need the other one as well. As you can see, 82 versus 32. So I guess we just need to, you know, equip a conductor and also make it a lot stronger. And I think this has an elemental attack. I'm not sure what it has. Oh well, only physical energy. But again, if we unlock the mastery for it, it will be a lot better. Now let's use the cube to go back. I think this cube is broken because it's never worked. Oh, now it's working, of course. And let's see how much actions we have to pay for it. It will actually work a little bit on the fuse column as well, because I want to kind of show you everything you need to know before you know it. Some people will say it's not worth it and the video should be a lot shorter, but hey, timestamps. That's why they are there. I also tend to waste a lot of time doing nothing in these videos because I want to explain so much more. And, you know, this is kind of like the product of a lot of hours of work. It's not going to be easy. So let's go over here again. And at the end of the video, I'll go back to the crafting area. Okay, the knight is sitting there peacefully. This actually looks pretty good. Imagine that you have a weapon that shouldn't be a weapon, that is infused with demonic energy. Well, that's kind of bad. But I like how the game gives you the option to use occult weapons and all those things. So we should get another strength based weapon in here. And that's why I choose to do these videos together, because some people just like the heavy weapons. Too slow. I hope he doesn't follow me here. So this is the place where you're born, the artificial pool. Bojack, so 100 and 408. That's actually a clever way to tell you the code. See, it's, that's, okay, you understand. That's a very funny way to do it, I like it. See, sometimes you don't even know how smart people really are. And this is the date of the stream, in case you are wondering why it's like this. It's nothing special. Facial hair, deliberate burden, heavy delivery. Please enjoy your stay. Okay, so let's see what weapon did we get. Deliberate burden. As you can see, it doesn't deal a lot of damage. But it looks kind of funny. It's basically an axe that is made again out of a piece of building material. Anyway, my guess is this is not really meant to be a real weapon, but they gave you anyway. So let's see, 24 strength, and the damage will not be as high as the other ones, and tenacity is the same. No, the stats are much weaker, but I don't have the name required strength to use it anyway, so I'll just use that a bit later. And that's kind of everything I wanted to show for the video. Now we'll just head to the crafting station and actually craft what we have. And to be honest, I also want to put that chip inside the weapon, because I want to see some other thing about the infused column. And then will come the very, very hard part of actually using it against normal enemies. And I think when it's infused, it will glow much, much more. Okay, let's get to that part as well. Spock, beam me up, or Scotty. Or whatever I want to say, but sometimes people get that all wrong. And there was actually a movie that said beam me up Spock, which is kind of not right, but hey. It was a Japanese movie, so I forgive them. And I really need to get rid of these things. So let's put the conductor inside the infused column. Let's see what damage it... No, don't discard the changes. Oh, okay. I guess I also need to increase the level of it. Yeah, let's actually look at this thing. I want to see something else. Stealth ability. Well, I guess I can use this one. I have some other melee conductors, but I don't think they'll do you any good. So let's see if we can actually use the other one. Yeah, so it's plus one. Let's use it. So how much more damage does this do? 40. Well, I guess if you upgrade it to 4, it will kind of do the same damage. But it should scale a lot better with your skills, because this needs 12, and this needs 12 and 4 foresight. Power 40. 100, 12, 12. I guess it's basically the same thing, only that it looks cooler. Let's actually equip the skill for it. No, let's not visit the last bridge. I don't know how to activate this thing, but I'll try to figure it out. And we'll see each other next time. Bye.